and he would draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. So God wants us to forsake iniquity, and he wants us to stop being double-minded. He said it, we just got to rest in it. We got to believe it. That's another way that we can begin to hear the voice of God. Another way is seeking God. Seeking God's presence. It says, turn with Acts 17, 24 and 7. It said, God that made the world and all things therein, seeing that the Lord is of heaven and earth, dwelleth not in temple made with hands, neither is worshipped with men's hands, as though he needed anything, seeing he giveth to all life and breath and all things, have made one blood all nations for men for to dwell on the face of the earth, and have determined times appointed the bounds of their habitation, that they should seek the Lord, if heavily they may feel after him and find him, though he be not far from any of them. For in him we live and move and have our being, as certain as also your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring. So if we are children of God, we should be seeking God. And in his word, he said, we can seek after him and he ain't even far from us. If we draw nigh to him, he's going to draw near to us. So if we just begin seeking God, seeking him out of a pure and sincere heart, we're going to find him and he's going to tell us what to do and how to do it. And he's going to give us some assurances in his word. Deuteronomy 4, 29 and 30. Turn with me to Deuteronomy 4, 29 and 30. It said, but if from thence thou shalt seek the Lord thy God, thou shalt find him. If you seek him with all thy heart and with all thy soul, when thou art in tribulation and all these things will come upon thee, even in the latter days, if thou turn from to the Lord, thou shalt be obedient unto him, unto his voice. So in Deuteronomy, Moses was telling them that he's not going to get to see the promised land because, you know, he ended up smoking the rock and getting in trouble with God. But he let them know that, you know, if you ever get in trouble, if anything you ever get where you're out of the will of God, all you got to do in that day is seek him. He said, from this moment, if you seek the Lord, you're going to find him. He knew he was going to be away from them. So he was letting them know, if you seek the Lord, you're going to find him. If you ever in tribulation and you turn that moment and you seek God, you are going to find him. And that promise stands today. And the day that you seek the Lord with your whole sincere heart, you're going to find him and he's going to speak to you. I got one more scripture. And it's James 1, 21 through 24. It said, wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness and receive with meekness the engrafted word which is able to save your soul. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. If any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholding himself and goeth his way and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. So when we get ready to hear the voice of God and God is speaking to us, we need to also be doers of the word. It makes no sense to hear God saying that you're this, you're that. He's going to do this for you. Come up higher, this and that, and you don't do it. It says you like a man that look at a mirror and see your face, and then when you turn around, you don't even remember what you look like. That don't make sense. So we need to be doers of the word. When God speaks to us, we need to do what God is telling us to do, and we're going to get some awesome results. And God just wanted me to say, if y'all will, and if it's okay, Pastor Jay, commit the remainder of this year to seeking God, to hear his voice more clearly. Make time for him in prayer. Keep a pen and a piece of paper by your bed so that you can write down your dreams and the different things God is telling you to do. Back in the hands of God.